Hi dear friends and subscribers, welcome to a cricket happening show which is going to be full of excitement and noise here, because what a match we had. A sensational match came to an end in the Asia Cup, which actually clinched Pakistan a spot in the final. So it has been decided that Pakistan will clash with Sri Lanka on Saturday in the Asia Cup final 2014. But let me tell you, the way Pakistan went into the final, that is what I was going to talk about. So today, what I'm going to look at is, one is going to look at the sensational match where more than probably 650 runs were scored in this particular match. And in the end, Pakistan were the victors with Shahid Afridi's blitzkrieg knock, really taking them home. And Shahid Afridi has definitely made it a habit in the Asia Cup to come and give his team a victory. What a knock from Shahid Afridi. He slammed the second fastest half century in one day international cricket. And one has seen Shahid Afridi play with such flair in the past, where he had murdered all the bowlers. But today, this was something really special, because I was under the feeling that, you know, probably Shahid Afridi has lost that bit of a punch, has lost that bit of the power with the age. But well, I would say age has not withered his power at all. He has sent the ball soaring over the pickets seven times. He hit seven sixes in that knock. It's a blitzkrieg knock. I will call this a blitzkrieg knock, because it really he went and pounded the Bangladeshi bowlers at a time when Pakistan had to required 102 runs of 51 balls. In walked Shahid Afridi, and look at what damage he did. He was the one who actually took them to victory by slamming the second fastest 50 in one day history, making 59 runs of just 25 deliveries with 2 fours and 7 sixes. And let's look at the sixes that he hit. Before that, yes, I'm going to look at the sixes that he hit, and then we will come to that. Well, Shahid Afridi walked in at a situation, as I said. First, let me just give you a brief summary of what really happened, so that you understand when Shahid Afridi came in and what was the damage he created. Well, first and foremost, this was a match in the Asia Cup where, for the first time, both the teams actually reached 300 runs. This was the first time the 300 mark was touched in Asia Cup 2014. And Bangladesh, can you believe it? They actually had their highest score in highest total in one day history today by making 326 for 3 wickets of their 50 overs. And it looked like it was going to be a very stiff task, because Bangladesh had racked up their highest ever total in ODI history. And for Pakistan, you know what they did? They did one better than what Bangladesh did, by doing something that they have never done before. They successfully chased the target of 326, and this was the most successful chase ever done by Pakistan in their ODI history. So history was definitely created. History was definitely made today at the Sher-e-Bangla National Stadium. And let me tell you, even though the Bangladeshi fans would be disappointed, I would say any spectator who actually watched this match today with Shahid Afridi, the blazing away that runs, that's as I said, he made 59 runs. He came at a point when Pakistan were really, it was very difficult for them. They were 225 for 5 when Abdul Rahman departed. He came in the 42nd over, and as I said, 102 runs were required of 51 balls. And look what Shahid Afridi did. He ransacked runs. He had a partnership with Fawad Alam, who also played a very compact little innings and later on opened out. But Shahid Afridi slamming 59 runs of 25 balls with 2 fours and 7 sixes. 7 sixes hit with awesome power, and he took the man of the match for the second time. So let's look at how things panned out. Bangladesh, as I said, they racked up their highest ever score in ODI history, making 326 for 3. It was all in the thanks mainly to Anamul Haq, who went on to his second one-day international century. He played some brilliant strokes, and this was an innings which was interspersed with brief patience and sometimes some good hitting, and he hit some very good sixes. He hit some enormous sixes on the bowling of Umar Gul. He hit sixes of Mohammad Thala, and Anamul Haq got his second ODI tan, making 100 of 132 balls with 6 fours and 4 sixes. Imrul Case, his partner, well, he contributed another wonderful knock of 59, making his comeback in the ODI after making his comeback into the test matches. He played well once again in the one day also. He made it count by slamming 59 runs of 75 balls with 5 fours and 2 sixes. Mominul Haq, as usual, contributing 51 of 47 balls with 6 fours. Each and every person hit a half century in this particular knock of 326 for 3. Mushfiqur Rahim was not out on 51 of 33 balls with 8 fours. And Shakib Ul Hasan, who came into this match, who made a comeback and showed why he is such an important person in this Bangladeshi team by making an unbeaten 44 of just 16 deliveries with 6 fours and 2 sixes, which took this Bangladesh score to an enormous and the highest ever total registered by Bangladesh in their ODI history of 326 for 3 wickets of their 50 overs. And still, that was not enough, as Pakistan usurped that total with lots of gumption, with lots of pride, I would say. Now let's look at the bowling. Now look at the, how the what happened with the Pakistani bowling. Let's look at the normally, you know, normally one would expect like Umar Gul, who is a prime strike bowler, to bowl well. He went for 76 runs, 10 overs unmade, and 76 runs on no wicket. Saeed Ajmal, the world's best spinner, off spinner, was taken for 61 runs of his 10 overs with 2 wickets. Shahid Afridi went for 64 of his 10, didn't really matter. He came and bludgeoned the Bangladeshi bowling with his bat. Saeed Maqsood bowled 1 over for 7 runs. Thala today was very costly in his second one day match. Second over, 7 overs, no made, and 1 for 68. 2 overs for 12 runs for Fawad Alam, who made a comeback into the Pakistani team, and how beautifully he made it count by playing that compact little knock of 74, just nurdling along the runs till such time when he opened out and hit Abdul Razak for 2 sixes in the penultimate over when 33 runs were required. At that time, Fawad Alam came good and slammed 2 sixes, and that was his third six. He has only hit 3 sixes in his entire international career. What a shot, what shots they were. They were absolutely out of the screws, I would say. And then Abdul Rahman, let's talk about Abdul Rahman. Let's talk about Mohammad Hafeez. Hafeez was the most economical bowler either side. 10 overs, no made, and none for 27. And look at Abdul Rahman. Look at his bowling figures. Zero overs. Zero balls, zero maidens, 8 runs. Do you know why it happened? Because he bowled 3 full tosses over waist height. And according to the ICC rules, according to the conditions, if you bowl 3 balls above the waist height, then you would be removed from the attack. And that's what precisely happened. And that is the reason I would say Misbah ul Haq, the captain of Pakistan, was put into a real quandary as to how he's going to, what he's going to do. And then he had to resort to the other bowlers. Otherwise, Abdul Rahman could have bowled his full quota. And this has never happened in international cricket, where Abdul Rahman bowled 3 full tosses above the waist and he went for 8 runs. And the umpire said he wouldn't be able to bowl any longer in this particular match. And so Bangladesh, after making 326, one would have thought that, you know, 327 is going to be a very, very stiff task. And it was an important match for Pakistan too. They had to get into the final pretty quickly. And well, the way they started, what was good about Pakistan was that they decided that they had a sort of they had actually made up their mind that they are going to chase this target. The openers, Ahmed Shahzad and Mohammad Hafeez, gave them a good start. Ahmed Shahzad in particular was very sedate. I mean, it was very good to see, because it was very essential that they got a good opening start, and they also kept their wickets intact. And that was the reason today that Pakistan won, because Ahmed Shahzad and Mohammad Hafeez put on a 97 runs partnership for the first wicket, with Hafeez contributing 52 of 55 balls with 8 fours. Ahmed Shahzad went on to make a century, and as I said, he played in a very, very calm and composed way. As you know, he has become a more mature cricketer nowadays, and also he plays some exquisite strokes. And he was there. He was the one who was along with. When Ahmed Shahzad was playing, as I said, he was really punishing the loose deliveries, but he was also playing very well. In fact, he was really playing very intelligently. And then suddenly, Pakistan, after getting that opening start, suddenly had a stutter as they lost Misbah ul Haq, the captain, who was clean bowled by Shakib Ul Hasan. Since Shakib Ul Hasan coming into the Bangladeshi team, I thought he did a great job, and also he's a very vital person in this Bangladeshi team. He came in and picked up the wicket of Misbah ul Haq, who was bowled for 4, and Shoaib Maqsood unfortunately was just caught behind Bayanamul Haq of the bowling, Muminul Haq for two. He was not happy with the decision, and rightly so, 105 for 3 in the 23rd over. And after that, Ahmed Shahzad played some very nice strokes and went on to 103 of 123 balls with 12 fours and 1 6, being a victim of Abdul Razak. And then Fawad Alam came in, and at that time it was looking very difficult for Pakistan to reach the target. It was looking a pretty tall one. Abdul Rahman was prevented in the batting order. Not only with the ball, with the bat also he failed. He was out for 8, and 225 for 5 was the score. And that is the time the man entered, and his name is Shahid Afridi. And Shahid Afridi entered. I'll tell you what happened. We will talk about how Shahid Afridi handled the Bangladeshi attack. And this is what Shahid Afridi did to take the match away from Bangladesh, and Pakistan won the match. In fact, Shahid Afridi came in, and the first delivery itself that he faced from Mahmoodullah, he connected it over long on, and it went for a six. That was the first six of the bowling of Mahmoodullah. The fifth delivery, which was bowled by Mahmoodullah, it was blasted, absolutely blasted by him. He made room for himself outside the leg stump and blasted him into the stands for a six. And so that was the two sixes. The third six, Shakib Ul Hasan now, coming under the real pump as far as Afridi is concerned, as Shakib Ul Hasan's first delivery was sent over long on for a six. What a shot that was. He was on one knee to actually smote it down, and then Shakib Ul Hasan was smoked over long off for another six. And then one more six followed with absolutely awesome power, as that went over square leg for a six. And this partnership, like Shahid Afridi was taking on the Bangladeshi bowlers, and he was really, really tearing their attack to shreds. And what Shahid Afridi had done, and after that one more six came, that was in the bowling of Shafiul Islam. Shafiul Islam was hit over mid-wicket for a six, and he could have become the fastest half century in one day internationals if he had hit one more run, but unfortunately that was not to be. So the fastest half century has been hit by the now chairman of selectors for Sri Lanka, Sanath Jayasuriya, as you know. And then Shahid Afridi was there, but he was limping, and he asked for a runner from the umpire, but the umpire denied it. And then he was also dropped by Mushfiqur Rahim, but it just proved a bit costly, I would say, because Afridi also hammered Al-Humin Hussain for another six over the fine leg boundary, and this was the damage he created before getting out, and he had ensured that Pakistan will be reaching the finals with a knock, where he was run out for 59. That's all because of his running, because he couldn't really run to the other end, and that was the precise reason he was out. But what a knock. Run out 59 of just 25 deliveries, 2 fours and 7 sixes. Absolutely smoked the Bangladeshi bowling all across the park. And then at that time when Shahid Afridi went, Umar Akmal walked in. You know, he's a form man. And the equation was they required still 33 runs from 18 balls, and that was the 48th over. Abdul Razak, as I said, Fawad Alam, who has been playing very, very sedately till then, suddenly got into his element, and he sent the ball, the second ball that Razak bowled, into the long on territory for a six. And then he also hit one more six, and this was this went into the Pakistani dugout, as this was also the highest score made by Fawad Alam, and as I said, it was his third six of his entire one day international career, as he put lots of power into it and punch into it and sent it soaring over the skies for another six. So two sixes. So that really helped matters. And after that, at the end of over 48, 13 runs were required from 12 balls, but Shakib Ul Hasan bowled an over where he gave 10 runs in that particular over, and in the 50th over the task became pretty easy, but there was some real tension, I would say, because Al-Hamin Hussain was bowling well, and he had kept the runs to a minimum. In fact, he kept the runs to the minimum, not giving any runs in the first two balls, and then he gave just one run. And not only that, he also picked up the wicket of Fawad Alam, who was run out for, he didn't pick up the wicket, he was run out, and suddenly there was some pressure with two of two balls required, but Umar Akmal, just set everything to rest by creaming one through the offside for a boundary, and that was it. Pakistan had reached the finals. So So Pakistan will play Sri Lanka in the finals of Asia Cup 2014. And congratulations to Pakistan and commiserations to Bangladesh for putting up a good show. Well, let's look at the bowling card. As I said, Shufawat Alam registered his highest ever score, 74 of 70 balls, 4 fours and 2 sixes. Shahid Afridi smashing 59. Umar Akmal not out 14 of 9 balls with 2 fours. Umar Gul not out not. Let's look at the bowling figures. Shafiul Islam's 5 overs went for 49. Al Amin Hussain had thought he bowled well, 6.5 overs, no made in 50 runs and no wicket. Shakib Al Hassan coming in. Until such time, he got a severe tap from Shahid Afridi. He was good. 10 overs, 2 made in 1 for 53. Razak bowled 9 overs, 1 for 72. Taken to the cleaners. Mominul Haq was the very economical bowler. 9 overs, 1 made in 2 for 37. Mahmudullah, 7 overs, 1 made in 147. Also bowled well. Nasir Hussain, 3 overs for 17. The player of the match, no doubt about it, was Shahid Afridi. Since I don't have time on the YouTube broadcast, I'm going to really, really wrap it up. As you know, Graham Smith, the South African captain, has announced his retirement. And Australia, it is a situation where Australia today started at the overnight score. David Warner went on to make back-to-back centuries in this one-day test match, where he had 2 centuries now. First innings also he scored a century. Now in the second innings also he scored 145, 13 balls, 4 fours. Other than that, I don't have time to really talk about it. 303 for 5 was what Australia finished with, just setting a target of more than 511 runs to actually win. And South Africa were in under immense pressure here, with Mitchell Johnson striking hard. In fact, he has picked up 2 wickets. Ryan Harris has picked up 1 wicket. James Pattinson with his pace has picked up 1 wicket. And South Africa really, really struggling at 71 for 4 at close of play on the 4th day. And it looked like Australia will be taking the series with the final day coming up tomorrow. AB de Villiers was not out on 16 of 1-4. And Graham Smith in his last innings in his test career, in his entire international career, was sent to the pavilion by Johnson, caught by Doolan for 3. And Graham Smith, the South African captain, bid adieu to international cricket. So the only one thing that South Africa can say, they have a huge, they have a big task on hand. It is a very, very impossible task. They have to score 440 runs, but whether AB de Villiers and Du Plessis, who's still there in the hut, can come and do a repeat as what they did at the Adelaide Oval in Australia, that remains to be seen. But again, it's a very, very stiff task. 440 runs. I don't think there's only one way this match can go, and that would be Australia will be winning the series, and South Africa have to still wait for getting a test series win over Australia at home. Well, dear fans and subscribers, I don't have anything else to share. I have to wrap up this Cricket Happening show, unfortunately, due to other commitments. Thanks for your company and thanks for regularly watching Cricket Happenings and also for your regular contributions to this cricket show. This is your host, Ram, signing off for the day on a very, very happy note. Thank you.